Hey, it's Cornelius. I got the new Galaxy S9 Plus. We're going to be doing an unboxing. Stay tuned. So this is the Galaxy S9 Plus. Just released on Friday. Comes in its signature black box with the logo on the front. 64 gigabytes. And I opted for the unlocked version. Got it directly from Samsung instead of T-Mobile, which is my carrier. If you trade this phone in right now, you can actually get up to 350 for your old phone, depending on which model you have. We're gonna go ahead and open it here. All right, so we've got a little box on top. Has a key. Quick reference guides and brochures. We'll put that to the side. And this is the Galaxy. You see that screen goes all the way to the edge. Now, before this one, I'm actually using a Galaxy S7. We've got your SIM card port up top. We've got your power button on the side here. Headphone ports are still here. See that dual camera, power button in the back, as well as a fingerprint reader. We've got your volume up and down on the left side. See if it has any battery. We'll let that boot up. Now, a little bit about this phone. Now, this is the S9 Plus. It does come in three colors. So we've got black, there's lilac purple, and then we have the blue, which is what I opted for. The screen is 6.2 inches, and it's a quad HD Super AMOLED. And it's 2960 by 1440 with 529 pixels. Of course, the S9 does have a few more pixels because the screen is smaller. All right, looks like that's booted up. Now, for many of you who wonder if I'm an Android fan or a iOS fan, the answer is actually neither. I'm currently holding in my hands a Lumia 950 XL. I actually prefer a Windows phone over both Android and iOS. For me, it's not really about the apps, it's about the productivity. And I feel like I get a better experience on the Windows phone than I do on both of these. One thing that usually keeps me from the Android phones is the lag. So I have the S7 and I use it mostly just to do Uber. I'm a driver, part-time. I'm also a realtor, so I have a few real estate apps on there. And I feel like the phone, it gets very sluggish, with the apps that I add on there. So I can't really use it for much, so it's always my second device. So I'm actually going to take a challenge with this one, and I'm going to try and use this one for an entire week without reverting to my Windows phone, and we're gonna see how that goes. So I'll actually be posting up the results as well. Now, one thing that Samsung talks about with this phone, what they really try to get across, is the camera. So the camera has been improved. this one has a 8 megapixel autofocus sensor. You can do, selfie focus. There's selfie that's wide selfie, and it actually switches the apertures. So you can switch between day and night. The camera automatically switches the aperture for you so that you can capture the image. Now, how well the image comes out, I mean, from the commercials and the website, it looks great. I'm a photographer, so I'm actually going to put that to a test, and we're going to test it versus the 950, and I'm going to test it versus my DSLR and see how it works out, see how good the camera is. So far, I love my 950 XL, and there hasn't really been a phone that I've wanted to get to replace it that does better. So I'm going to really test this phone out for a week. Now, this phone, it does have a few new apps, such as the emoji app, which is similar to what Apple has for their phone. You can make yourself an emoji, and it actually replicates, the motion, but in a, cartoon, realistic way. So as I get this set up, I'll talk more about that and go through it with you. This phone does come with a pretty good amount of storage. I mean, it comes with 64 gigabytes, but you can expand it up to 400 gigabytes. So that's quite a bit of storage on a phone. This is the unlocked version, so I imagine it doesn't come with as many bloated apps as the ones from the carriers come with. So off the bat, it should be pretty fast. I mean, it's 6 gigabyte memory. You should be able to run multiple tasks simultaneously without it slowing down. And so that's what I'm expecting from this phone when I turn it on, when I go throughout the day. Now, I know there's a few things I'm gonna miss on it from my Windows phone, but I'm gonna try to get by with those for the week and see how it works out. One of the things, this camera, the phone, they tout as the super slow motion. So they have a feature where this phone, it will, take the video that you're shooting, and it's going to make it really slow so that you can get those cool effects. So if you're not really into slow motion, it's probably really not going to matter to you. For the average user, they just want a camera that's good or good enough. For us photographers, you want a camera that's great. So, I mean, it depends on what you're looking for. This camera does have a handheld translator. So what that means is if you point that the camera, if you pick up the phone and point the camera at something that's say in Spanish or French or whatever, it's going to translate it into the language that you need it to do. If any of you have ever used a Windows phone, that's a feature that we've had for a while. So I'm happy to see that come over. I'm also happy to see Microsoft, I guess, working with Android and bringing a lot of its software over for those of us who, need to switch because Windows Phone is going away. That way we can still use the apps or software that we need to use. I'm going to go ahead and set this up real quick. And then I'm going to come back and we're going to play with it. So I'm walking through the setup right now. One thing I do like is that when you turn it on, it does allow you to move over your apps from your previous device. So if you were previously using a Samsung phone, you can actually put all the apps that you were already using through there. And not put the ones that you don't want. So I'm going through and just clicking the apps that I want and then leaving everything else off. And of course I'm not choosing any of the Google apps or any of the Samsung apps because those will probably be on the phone already and I don't want to make doubles of them. So I had I mean, quite a few apps in the other one. Most of them are Google and Samsung apps. And then, of course, I had to move all of the Microsoft apps over. All right, and we'll finish up that, and then we'll go ahead and get to the review and see how it works. One of the things I've enjoyed about the 950 XL is the ability to log into the phone with my eyes versus typing in a pen or email. Although sometimes there are times where you will need to use one of those. For example, when you restart the phone, you have to log in with a PIN number. You can't use your eyes. So the Galaxy, they've come up with pretty much all of them. So you've got the intelligent scan, you've got the face recognition, iris scanner, fingerprint scanner, set up a PIN, password, whatever works for you, you can use it to log into the device. So I'm actually gonna set that up in a second. I'm gonna move this to the side because while this was setting up, I remembered I didn't finish, you know, taking everything out of the box, and I'm gonna do that now. So we've taken out the phone already. So of course we have the charger. Comes in black. The last one that I have for the S7 is white. We've got a USB connector. And it's cool because this one is actually Type-C, which is just like the phone that I currently have. If you don't have a Type-C charger, something great about it is that it charges your phone really fast. So I can charge my Windows phone up to, you know, 50% in just like a few minutes. So we've got these new AKG headphones. Now the audio inside of the new Galaxy has been tuned by AKG. So it's supposed to sound amazing. We're actually gonna test that out. We're gonna see if it sounds amazing. And of course we've got the USB connector. And again, it's Type-C. So if you're unboxing this for the first time, you should probably plug it up and charge it before you start using it. I'm at 63% right now. I'm just gonna let that run while I do this video, and then we'll charge it up. So we're gonna put all that back. And I'm gonna finish setting up this scanner here. And I'll be right back. All right, so far I've been playing with it. I set it up. And you can see what it looks like here. Now, I've been using Microsoft Launcher on the S7. So I don't remember what the default Android looks like. So I went ahead and uninstalled the Microsoft Launcher because it did restore my apps and it set my screen exactly like the S7 was. Excuse me, I'm a little sick here. So I did uninstall the Microsoft Launcher. That way we could get a look of what the stock Android looks like. And again, this is the unlocked version. So it's not gonna come with all of the apps that you may get from your carrier. It's not gonna come with like all the Google stuff. It's gonna be just minimal. Basically whatever you install from your previous device. So this is the stock look of Android 8.0, which is Oreo. Again, we have the weather, the city, everything is up there. Things at the bottom here. It's pretty responsive. I mean, so far so good, but we do expect a phone to work like this out of the box. The problem comes when you add too many apps and it starts to get sluggish. So that's what I'm going to be testing out for the week. when I tap apps, they open pretty fast. So they're pretty responsive. This is my first time actually opening the camera, so it's giving me instructions. And we'll play with that in just a second. Now I use a Microsoft for almost everything on the S7. I don't really use the Google services. I use Cortana versus the Google Now. This one actually has Bixby built in, so I'm gonna try it out and see what it's like. But yeah, everything is pretty good. I haven't set up the Play Store yet, but it's all here. It's all good. So I mean, everything looks like it works. Now what I didn't find is the new emoji thing that Samsung has. Now it's in here somewhere. I'll have to find it and then I'll update this on the app here. So that is something that we'd have to look for. I mean, my Bitmoji is there, but I don't see the regular. Now, unless it's in the camera app. Let's go ahead and open the camera a little bit here. Let's see this. So, quality's pretty good. Now, because I'm recording this through another phone, I don't know if the full quality is coming through. There we go. But the quality is actually pretty good. And then let's see if we can switch. Alright, so I actually found the AR emoji. It's actually in your camera, so when you open up the camera, you'll see it at the top there, along with a few other things, like that super slow-mo, which we'll talk about in just a bit. Yes. Now, the AR emoji, you snap a picture of your face, and it makes you into this digital character, so that you can use it while you're texting or using apps or whatever. Now, this is the face it got for me. It's almost true. The eyebrows are kind of good. It does have, like, you know, the little mole by the nose. It doesn't have the facial hair on the side, but it did capture the chin. It even has a few little gray stragglers at the bottom, which is not that bad. Now, the hair, if you're a black guy like me, it doesn't come out quite 100%, but this will do. So you can go ahead and change your hairstyles. You know, you can change, you know, the colors or whatever. You can change your skin tone. You can add glasses. Is it like we have a special language? And you can add clothing. So you can go through and pick what works for you. I'm gonna go ahead and go with this red polo and jeans here. So again, I found the AR emoji, and it's actually at the top of the screen when you're playing with the camera. As you can see, looks kind of like me. Move your eyebrows and move your lips. Now, it's not 100% accurate, but I mean, it's meant to be fun. Oh, it looks like it actually closed. See if we can bring it back up. Where's it at? AR emoji.
There we go. And sorry, I'm actually gonna flip this over a little bit. All right, so there we go. A-R-E-M-O-G. I don't know. Are y'all feeling it? I mean, it's all right. It's animated. It's meant to be fun. It's not going to be perfect. However, I'm sure Samsung will probably make some improvements to it. So that's good for now. Let's go through the rest of the camera settings. All right, let's stop this one. All right, so we've got wide selfie. We've got air emoji. Again, we've got selfie. We've got selfie focus. And actually, you know what? I think that's because I pressed on the wide selfie. So let me get out of that. Okay, actually. So it looks like these are because I'm on the front-facing camera. So if you actually get off of the front-facing, which is this button right here, it actually gives you the other settings. So we've got a food, we've got a panorama, we've got a pro, we've got a live focus, we've got an auto, we've got a super slow-mo. Now let's talk about the super slow-mo for a second. I'm gonna pick up this auto here and show you what it looks like. This is auto, right? Pretty bright, looks good. Nice HD quality. Now I love the camera on my Lumia 950XL, but I'm gonna say that this camera in autofocus mode, or actually pretty much anything except super slow-mo, looks pretty decent. Like, it's really clear. So I'm gonna switch to this super slow mode here. Now what you're supposed to do is hold it, and when someone enters the square, it will automatically capture the slow motion. But as you can tell, the screen got darker. Now capturing something in slow-mo isn't really worth it if you can't see it. So I'm pretty sure this mode will only be useful for outdoors or somewhere where there's a lot of light. Now, even though there's a lot of light in here, there's not enough for the super slow-mo. So overall, it's pretty good. Besides the slow-mo, it's the only downside I see right now. I'm gonna test that out more when it's daytime, so we can get a better view of it. Now, I did get one capture of the slow-mo. It was pretty good, but you know, the Lumia 950 comes with a slow-mo mode, and I feel like it's not much different. And the Lumia captures slow-mo in dark settings. So for the same amount of light that I had in the room for the Galaxy, I have both phones doing capturing the recording at the same time. And the Lumia, it stays the same for both camera and slow motion, versus the Galaxy gets darker when I try to do the slow-mo. So we'll try to figure that out. Maybe it's like a setting or something that I need to tweak, but we'll see if that works later in the week. I'm gonna test out something else here. Let's say Instagram. I am loving this this screen that goes all the way to the edge here, because you get more real estate, as you can say. Now, so far it's pretty fast. In the Instagram, I'm using, you know, my home network. So I think some apps will depend on how fast your network is, but otherwise it's pretty snappy. We're gonna try some music here. Now for me, when I get a phone, some of the most important things I look for is the ability for the phone to be fast, no matter how many apps I put on it. It has to have a great camera, because I like to capture everything. And it has to have sound because I love music. Okay, so we're gonna test out Pandora here. Let's test something that has a little bit of bass in it. Let's see how this sounds. All right, looks like the network may be a little slow. I don't know why. Oh, there we go.
Hey, yo, let me take the ass back to the club real quick. Watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it. Touch it, bring it, fade. Watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it. Touch it, bring it, fade. Watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it. Touch it, bring it, fade. Watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it. Who be king of the sound? Bust a bus back to just put a lock on the town. Now that my bitch be coming for miles around. She need be coming because they know how the gods are. Turn it up, make it know who holding the throne. So give me the crown. Saluting the tr-
It's okay. I'm not impressed with it. Let's see something else. Now again, there may be some
I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State.